This call is now being recorded.
So structural hazards, we said, occur when some resources has not been duplicated enough to allow all combinations of instructions in the pipeline to execute. So we gave the example with one memory port, a data and an instruction fetch cannot be initiated in the same clock. Is my voice audible there?
Yes, sir.
So the pipeline is installed for a structural hazard, and that means two loads with one port memory is there, or you can say the two port memory will serve without stall. So we discussed about the structural hazard yesterday. Now talking about the data hazards. So it is the one of the important, you can say whenever you are talking, yeah, you are running any of the program, the interrupt in your program can be occur either in the form of to take the input through user. So basically, whenever you are taking the data through user, a hazards can be occur that is basically known as the data hazards. So occurs when the execution of an instruction depends on the result of a previous instruction. So data hazard can be deal with either hardware technique or software technique. So basically we are saying that data hazards is a maybe occur due to the problem of the hardware and also maybe occur due to the problem of the software. Such as yesterday we discussed about some of the program and where we are taking the input through user for the addition of the two number. So basically we want to take the two number as an input. If we enter the null character as an input in a program, then in that situations we will see again whenever we are again inputting the sum of the value, then where the null character already has been inserted inside the memory, we see that the new value is not going to be possible in the previous memory. So that is the one type of hazard. And for removing that in C language, in generally, whenever you will study C, you will study the concept that is flushing of the memory. That is the flush stdin. There is a concept by which you can clear the previous memory data. That is exactly the null character presented in the memory. So whenever you want to remove the null character from your memory, you use the flush stdin, that is a function present in the C language and flush in C++ language. So basically, we see the problem of data hazard right there, that previous content, whatever present memory, we are unable to delete that content. Content is not going to be accepted by the memory. So that is the data hazard, that is the one type of data hazard occurred inside the memory. So we are saying here, it occurs when the execution of an instruction depends on the results of a previous instruction. Since we want to add R1, R2, R3, it means add the content of register R2 and R3 and store the result in the register R1 is there. Again, if we write subtract R4, R1, R5, add the content of register R1, that is the result of the previous instructions, and add it with the register, subtract the R5 from the register R1 and finally store the result at the position of the R4 is there. So it can create the hazards, and such type of hazards that is related to data will known as the data hazard. So data hazard can be dealt with either hardware technique or can be dealt with the software technique. So it can dealt with hardware or software technique both. So hardware technique, we are saying here that is the interlocking technique is there. So hardware detects the data dependencies and delays the scheduling of the dependent instructions by installing enough clock cycles. So interlocking of the hardware component, the memory of interlocking of the memory is possible. And due to interlocking, hardware detects the data dependencies and delays the scheduling of the dependent instructions by installing enough clock cycles. Whenever we talk about the another technique, that is the forwarding. That it means इट इज द बाईपासिंग टेक्निक और शॉर्ट सर्किटिंग टेक्निक. वेन एवर यू टॉक अबाउट शॉर्ट सर्किटिंग, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द केस ऑफ द सी लैंग्वेज, द शॉर्ट सर्किटिंग कैन बी अचीव आइदर बाय द एंड ऑपरेटर और बाय द और ऑपरेटर. सो वी आर टॉकिंग हियर द सेम. वेन एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द डाटा हजार्ड, द शॉर्ट सर्किटिंग एंड बाईपासिंग इज पॉसिबल एंड दैट इज बेसिकली नोन एज द फॉरवर्डिंग. इन केस ऑफ फॉरवर्डिंग मीन्स टू से इन द केस ऑफ शॉर्ट सर्किटिंग और बाईपासिंग, द डाटा हजार्ड कैन बी अकर एट अगेन. सो इट अकम्प्लिश्ड बाई अ डाटा पाथ थ्रू रूट्स अ वैल्यू फ्रॉम अ सोर्स यूजुअली एन अर्थमेटिकल लॉजिकल यूनिट टू अ यूजर बाईपासिंग अ डिजाइंड रजिस्टर. दिस अलाउज द वैल्यू टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड टू बी यूज एट एन अर्लियर स्टेज इन द पाइपलाइन देन वुड अदरवाइज बी पॉसिबल. द सॉफ्टवेयर टेक्निक इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल. द इंस्ट्रक्शन शेड्यूलिंग दैट इज कंपाइलर फॉर डिलेड लोड. सो फॉरवर्डिंग हार्डवेयर. सो वेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट द फॉरवर्डिंग हार्डवेयर, दिस इज द हार्डवेयर हैज बीन गिवन, रजिस्टर फाइल इज देयर एंड वेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट द रजिस्टर फाइल, द कंटेंट इज प्रेजेंट इन द रजिस्टर, कंटेंट इज ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट विद द रजिस्टर एंड दिस रजिस्टर कंटेंट. Whenever we want to process the register content, suppose we want to perform the addition, then memory content is basically present in the memory. We transfer the content of memory to the register. So register file is there. We are transferring the content from the register to memory. And finally, by using the bus, we are transferring the content to the multiplexer at there. Multiplexer processes the data and gives the input for the ALU. ALU again takes the action according to the functions whatever we have applied for the data values and store in another register, or we can say it send it onto the register and this register content again save onto the register file. So basically we want to say that we are performing here, that is add R1, R2, R3. So we want to perform this operation where we want to add the two registers value, that is R2 and R3, and want to store these two register value into the register R1 at there. Then after that, we subtract the R1 to R5. Basically, R1 is the previous register, previous content, and we want to subtract the content of register R1 to R5, and finally storing this content onto the register R4 is there. So this is the one of the example. We want to execute these instructions. Then in that situation, since these are the micro instructions, we want to execute these instructions and these are used in the programming. So basically this type of hazard can be achieved, can be acquired by the software, and this is the software data hazard. So three-stage pipeline, again the instruction fetch is there, instruction decode, read register and ALU operations are there, and write the result to the destination registers has been occur at here. So add operation will passes through all these three stages, subtraction will also passes through these three stages, and the bypassing also also that is the subtraction again access these three stages of the pipeline at there. Instruction scheduling. So whenever we talk about the instruction scheduling, A equals to B plus C or D equals to E minus F, like that, basically we want to say whenever we want to write any of the software, we generally write the instructions. So instructions always get executed by the CPU, and whenever the instructions get executed by the CPU, then in that situation, basically we want to say the scheduling of the instructions are very necessary part. So scheduling of the instructions, that such as two instructions has been written sequentially, that A assign the value B plus C and D assign the value E minus F, the scheduling of these two instructions is going to be required whenever we want to execute these instructions. So unscheduled code can be written like this way, that RB comma B is there, then load RB comma B is there. So load RB, load intent of B2, register RB at there. Load register, load content of C register to the RC is there. Now load content of memory C into the register RC is there. Then after that, add RA, RB, RC. Means to say we want to add the three components, now two components RB and RC, and want to store in the third A component, and another register RA is there. So like that. Like that. So we are writing here SW, that is the software, right? May be possible. And we are writing here A comma RA is there. So register RA content is going to be written back inside the memory. A is there. Then load W is there. Then register content, the load the content of memory E to register RE is there. Then load the content of memory F to the register RF is there. Again, RD register having the subtract RD comma RE comma RF. It means subtract the register content RF from the register content of RE and store finally into the RD register. And again, software, and this is the D, SN the value D comma RD. It means finally store the value of register RD inside the memory. D is there. So delayed load is there. A load requiring that the following instructions not use its results. Next, third is the control hazards are there. So basically in the data hazard, we are seeing the two type of hazards. One is the hardware based hazards, and another is the software based hazards. Now we are talking about the control hazards. So what the control is, whenever we said the word control in the term of computer science, basically we are talking about the control statement. And what the control statement is, definitely these control statements are if else, later if else, etc. For, while, do while, break, continue, go to, return, these all are basically known as the control statement is there. So control hazards may be possible. Branch instructions, branch target address is not known until the branch instruction is completed. We are saying here, whenever we talk about the branch instruction, the branch target address is not known. If we don't know that what is the address of the branch, next branch, then it is the problem. Then it is the problem, and it will generate the control hazard at there. So branch target address is not known until the branch instruction is completed. And it means to say, up to while the condition is not going to be fulfilled, up to while the condition is not going to be checked up properly, up to while we cannot get the branch instruction address, and in that situation, the instructions will never get completed. So branch instruction, that is the FIDA, F and EX. Next instructions, FIDA, F and EX, the target address value is going to be increased. So install waste of cycle. So basically we are saying here, a lot of time, the cycle waste is going to be occur at here. So dealing with control hazards, prefetch target instructions, we are saying ki whenever we want to deal with the branch control hazards, so we have a requirement to prefetch the target instructions. We have a requirement to branch target buffer. We have a requirement to branch target buffer. What is the loop buffer? We have a requirement to set the to check the loop buffer and the branch prediction. We have to predict the branch, from where the branch is going to be started, from where the another control is going to be started, as well as what is the branch is there, that is basically known as the delayed branch. Means to say, what is the instruction for what we are not getting the address of that particular instructions. So we are saying here the control hazards, that these are the control hazards, and whenever we want to deal with the control hazards, we have to focus on perfect target instructions, branch target buffer, loop buffer, branch prediction, as well delayed branch. We have to focus on that all. Prefetch target instruction, control hazards. So prefetch target instruction, fetch instructions in both streams, branch not taken and branch taken, both are saved until branch is executed. Then select the right instruction stream and discard the wrong stream. So branch target buffer, that is BTB, that is associative memory. Entry, address of previous executed branches, target instructions, and the next few instructions. When fetching an instructions, search branch target buffer. If found, has the instruction stream in the
branch target buffer. If not, then new stream is fetched and update branch target buffer. Whenever we talk about the loop buffer, high speed register file, loop buffer is basically known as the high speed register file, and it is particularly used for storage of entire loop that allows to execute a loop without accessing memory. So the branch prediction, guessing the branch condition and fetch an instruction stream based on the guesses, correct guess eliminates the branch penalty. Delayed branch, compiler detects the branch and rearranges the instruction sequence by inserting useful instructions that keep the pipeline busy in the presence of a branch instructions. So that is basically known as the control hazards. After that, we are studying that is the RISC pipeline. RISC pipeline, risk pipeline is there. RISC, reduced instruction set computer. Whenever we talk about the RISC, reduced instruction set computer, so we are saying what the RISC pipeline is there. So whenever we talk about the RISC pipeline, it means at what system we are sitting, they all are following the same configuration, and that configuration is basically known as the RISC configuration, that is the reduced instruction set computer configuration. And whenever we talk about the pipeline for the RISC computers, then it is the good thinking, this is the good nodes. So this is the RISC. So whenever we talk about the RISC, machine with very fast clock cycle that executes at the rate of one instruction per cycle. So basically we are saying here, whenever the one cycle moves on, the one instructions has been read on. So we are saying here, these are the fastest machines available today. So machines with a very fast clock cycle, and it become possible whenever the clock cycle of the instruction for the instruction is very much high. So machines with a very fast clock cycle that executes at the rate of one instruction per cycle is basically known as the RISC, the simple instruction set, and is based on fixed length instruction format. And another is that is register to register operation. So instruction cycles of three stage instructions pipeline: data manipulation instructions, load and storing instructions, program control instructions. So basically we want to say here, whenever we talk about the instruction cycles of the three stage instructions pipeline, so the instruction cycles can be read on that data manipulation instruction cycle is there, load and store instruction cycle is there, as well program control instructions are available there. So whenever we talk about the instruction cycles of the three stage instruction pipeline, the data manipulation instruction, it means we are talking about the instruction fetch, then after that decode, read registers and ALU operations, and finally write the data onto the register, and write a register operation is going to be correct there. Whenever we talk about the load and store instructions, first of all, instruction fetch is there, then decode and evaluate effective address, and finally register to memory or memory to register is data is going to be written, that is the load and store instruction is there. Either we will store the data from register to memory, that is basically known as the load operation, or either we will store the content from register to memory, and we will store the content from memory to register, then it is the load operation. And whenever we will store the content of register to memory, then it is basically known as the store operation. So this is the load and store instructions are available there. Next, program control instructions, the instruction fetch, decode, evaluate branch address is there. So whenever program control instructions are there, since your program contains the address of the instructions, then definitely program control instructions, the instruction fetch should be there, then after that decode should be there, then evaluate the branch address, then evaluate the branch address and write to the register at there. So we are saying here, whenever we talk about the instructions cycle of three stage instructions pipeline, The three types of instructions are available: data manipulation instructions, load and store instructions, program control instructions. So this is the pipeline. Timing has been shown. Some content is overloading. Delayed branch. So what do you mean by delayed branch? So compiler analyzes the instructions before and after the branch and rearranges the program sequence by inserting useful instructions in the delay steps using no operation instructions. So basically we are saying here, load is there, then increment, then add. And this is has been shown that 8-stage pipeline is available at here. Rearranging the instructions in the 6-stage pipeline, the clock cycle is running, then load is there, increment is there, branch to X is there, add address addition is there, subtraction is there, and instruction in X is there, and no operation has been resolved from here. So the instructions pipeline become little small. Next is vector processing, and vector processing is also known as the array processing. So vector processing and array processing both are same thing. So you will study the vector processing applications. So whenever we talk about the array processing and vector processing, in computer science, array is also known as the vector. So we can understand the array. If we talk about the array, it is the collection of memory that is present in the continuous fashion, continuous order. Or we can say the sequentially instructions are going to be executed within the array. So vector processing applications, this is the word, and it is most common word used in the computer science. That is the vector processing. The vector processing applications, the problems that can be efficiently formulated in terms of vectors. So long range weather forecasting is the applications, the vector processing having the applications in the long range weather forecasting. Suppose we want to calculate the forecasting of the weather, then it is feasible by using the vector processing applications that are the array based applications. Petroleum explorations, seismic data analysis, medical diagnosis, aerodynamics and space flight simulations, artificial intelligence and expert system, mapping the human genome, and image processing. So basically we are saying here that whenever we talk about the vector processing applications, the multiple variant areas are there where the vector processing is applicable. What the vector processor mean? So vector processor, that is the processor which having the ability to process vectors and related data structures such as matrices and multidimensional arrays much faster than combinational computers, then it is known as the vector processors may also be pipelined. So we are saying in that situation, the vector processor may also be pipelined. Some of the vector programming has been presented here that do 20 i equals to 1, 100 is there. 20, the 20th instruction presented here, that is ci equals to bi plus ai. The conventional computer, that is initialize I equals to 0, read AI, read BI, store CIS at the value AI plus BI, increment I equals to I plus 1, if I is less than equals to 100, go to 20. So this is the programming, a simple programming, simple instructions has been shown up here, just like the addition of the two number in C language. So vector computer, that C 1 to 100 is there, we want to add the number 1 to 100. A 1 to 100 is there, plus V is also 1 to 100 is there. So such type of programming is basically known as the vector programming. You can use the vector programming, but not in your syllabus. Next is vector instruction format. So vector instruction format, that is the operation code, then base address source code, and base address source code 2, base address destination code, vector length is there. Pipeline for inner product, that is source A and source B is there. we are sending the address or data from the source A and source B to the multiplier pipeline. And finally, by using the adder pipeline, we are adding the content of the source A and source B at there. So this is the, by using the method of array, we generally perform all the work, and that is basically known as the vector processing. So multiple memory module and interleaving. So whenever we talk about the memory module, multiple memory module are there. That is the AR means address register is there, memory array is there, data register is there. So basically we want to say that two type of buses has been shown at here. One is the address bus is there, which basically identify the address of each and every component present in the memory at there. Then after that, the address bus is there. The content of address bus is going to be represented by the AR, and AR send the data to the memory array. Memory array process the data and send it to the data register, and finally send it onto the data bus, and through the database it reaches onto the user, or you can say it reaches onto a you can say that is the display device where the user can see that all particular data which has been processed by the vector processor. Address interleaving. Different sets of addresses are assigned to different module, different memory modules. We are saying here there may be the different technique to identify the scheme, to identify the address of the memory. And whenever we are trying to identify some of the memory reading technique, then in that situations, different sets of addresses are assigned to different memory modules, and the interleaving may occur in particular situation. Means to say some memory may be possible which is not readed at one time, and after some time that memory is going to be readed. That is basically known as the address interleaving. Next is multiprocessors. So whenever we talk about the multiprocessors, the characteristics of the multiprocessors, then after that interconnection structure, then interprocessor arbitration and interprocessor communication and synchronization, and finally the cache coherence. We will study this all in the multiprocessors. So terminology in the multiprocessor, whatever we will study, such as parallel computing is there. Second, distributed computing is there. Third is concurrent computing is there. So these three type of terminology we will study whenever we will study about the multiprocessors. So multiprocessors, this is the general terminology. Simple, the term multiprocessor said that we have a single processor system, as well as we can have a system which having the multiprocessors are there. Right now, the maximum systems, whatever we purchase, whatever we use, that having the multiprocessors all together. We gave the example of that type of processors yesterday, that we told you that Core to Duo processor system is there, Duo to Core processor system is there, not even dual processor system is there. We have a system which having the multiple processors embedded within a single system with a multiple memory associated with them. So we said that the Flynn's classification of architecture, we follow MIMD architecture right now. That is the multi-instructions, multi-data architecture we generally follow whenever we talk about the multiprocessors. So we are saying here, what are the characteristics of the multiprocessors? We have to study here. What are the interconnection structures? How the two or more processors are associated to each other? That is the interconnection structures of the multiprocessor. Again, we study interprocessor arbitration. That processor arbitration is there. So just like the bus arbitration is there, that at a time one bus can be the master and another bus are the slave buses are there. In the same style, we are saying the interprocessor arbitration are there, that one CPU, one processor may be the master at a time, and it having the control of all the system, all the processor present in the system. So inter-processor communication and synchronization is there. We have to study it. And then after that, an important topic that is basically known as the cache coherence. We have to study the cache coherences there. So whenever we are talking about the terminology of the multiprocessor, we are saying here the parallel computing is there. Whenever we talk about the parallel computing, we use the concept of the multiprocessor. Whenever we talk about the concept of the distributed computing, in case of the concept of distributed computing, we also work onto the multiprocessor. Then concurrent computing means that we are talking about all of the above, that is basically known as the concurrent computing. Means to say, we are talking about the parallel computing, we are also talking about the distributed computing. Whenever we talk about the distributed computing, you can see the concept that such as you see the concept of the Play Store. Then if you see the concept of the Play Store, that work onto the Google Play Store or iOS Play Store works onto the concept of the distributed computing right now today. So parallel computing, a simultaneous use of multiple processors, that all components of a single architecture to solve
the problem.
Sir, aap to lecture finish hone wala hai, tab se aap bata rahe ho.
Sir, tab se compromise kar raha hu sir, main abhi bilkul nahi aa rahi hai.
Dragon lecture mein. Tab ja ke tum keh rahe ho ki aadha ghante se kya kar rahe the.
Sir, pehle सर आपकी आवाज
बेस्ट. आर यू सीइंग द स्लाइड्स? हेलो, आर स्लाइड्स विजिबल?
यस सर.
यस.
सो स्लाइड्स, इफ वी सी द स्लाइड्स, वी आर टॉकिंग द टॉपिक अबाउट द मल्टीप्रोसेसर. एंड मल्टीप्रोसेसर के दो एग्जांपल हमें दिखाई देते हैं यहाँ पर. एक तो हमें पैरेलल कंप्यूटिंग दिखाई देता है, दूसरा हमें डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड कंप्यूटिंग दिखाई देता है. तो हमने सिर्फ यहाँ पर अभी दो बातें बताई हैं आपको कि जब आप पैरेलल कंप्यूटिंग की बात कर रहे हैं तो बहुत सारे प्रोसेसर्स आपके साथ एसोसिएटेड हो सकते हैं. एक ही सिस्टम पर पैरेलल कंप्यूटिंग का आप एक तरह से देख सकते हैं कि एक ही सिस्टम है, वहां पर एक ही सिस्टम के अंदर मल्टीपल प्रोसेसर एसोसिएटेड हैं, दो अथवा दो से अधिक ज्यादा प्रोसेसर एसोसिएटेड हैं, उसको हमने कहा पैरेलल कंप्यूटिंग. दूसरा हमने कहा डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड कंप्यूटिंग. तो डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड कंप्यूटिंग में जैसे एक एग्जांपल हमने दिया कि गूगल का प्ले स्टोर आता है, तो गूगल का प्ले स्टोर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड कंप्यूटिंग का एक एग्जांपल है. आपने कोई अगर आप देखें तो आपने क्या किया कि आपने एक ऐप बना के तैयार किया और गूगल के प्ले स्टोर पर उसको इंस्टॉल कर दिया या रख दिया. देन आफ्टर दैट ईच एंड एवरी पर्सन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड डाउनलोड दैट पर्टिकुलर ऐप एंड उसको ऐसा दिखाई देता है कि वो पर्टिकुलर जो ऐप था वो उसके मोबाइल पर ही पड़ा हुआ है, दूसरी जगह पर नहीं है. तो दैट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड कंप्यूटिंग. So we are saying here that parallel computing, if we talk about the parallel computing, the simultaneous use of the multiprocessors, that is all components of the single architecture that solve a problem, that solve a common problem, typically processors is identical, single user, even if machine multi-user is there. Or we are saying here, it follow the MIMD architecture, whatever we have studied in the Flynn's classification. In the Flynn's classification, four types of architecture were there. One is the SISD architecture, single instruction, single data architecture. Then SIMD architecture, single instruction, multi-data architecture. Then MISD architecture, multi-instruction, single data architecture. But no such system available till today in the MISD architecture. And last was the MIMD architecture, multi-instruction, multi-data architecture is there, where we are saying that onto a system, multiple processor can exist as well as multiple memory can also exist onto a single system. And that is the best example of the parallel computing. Then distributed computing, that is use of a network of processors that each capable of being viewed as computer in its own right to solve a problem. Processors may be heterogeneous, multi-user, usually individual task is assigned to a single processor. That is basically known as the distributed computing. And both are parallel computing or distributed computing. Parallel computing ke behalf par cloud computing also. So cloud computing is also work onto the concept of the parallel computing. So parallel computing, distributed computing, both are commonly known as the concurrent computing. So we discussed it in the multiprocessor architecture. The multiprocessor is there. Then we will study about the parallel computing. We will study about the distributed computing. We will study about the concurrent computing. Indirectly, we will study about the cloud computing concept. Next is, what is the supercomputing, then pipelining, vector computing, and systolic system? Supercomputing, use of fastest, biggest machine to solve big computationally intensive problems. Historically, machines were vector computers, but parallel slash vector or parallel becoming the norm. Whenever we talk about the pipelining, breaking a task into steps performed by different units and multiple input stream, so the units with next input starting in a unit when previous input done with the unit but does not necessarily done with the task. Vector computing, use of vector processors, that is the array-based processors, where operations such as multiply broken into several steps and is applied to a stream of operands that is basically known as the vectors. Most common special case of pipelining is basically comes under the category of the vector processing. The systolic system, similar to pipelining, but units are not necessarily arranged linearly. Steps are typically small and more numerous, performed in lockstep fashion, often used in special purpose hardware such as image or signal processors. These are the some of the terminology we have to study or we have to know. Next is processor speed. We will study the processor speed in the next lecture. Speed up and efficiency of the processor. So, यहाँ तक अगर आपका कोई question बनता है, तो वो थोड़ा सा discuss करें. By the way, MDLD law है ना, ये आपके दोनों ही syllabus का part नहीं है, लेकिन knowledge होना चाहिए. तो simple यहाँ पर ये कहा गया है processor speed में कि हर 18 महीने के गुजरने पर आपके जो processor है, उसकी speed almost double हो जाती है. हम पहले भी discuss कर चुके हैं. एज वेल मेमोरी के केस में भी ऐसा ही है कि हर 18 महीने के गुजरने पर मेमोरी का साइज भी ऑलमोस्ट क्या हो जाता है, डबल हो जाता है. वर्ल्ड का सर्वे अभी तक यही कहता है. यस, हैव यू एनी क्वेश्चन? हेलो, सो हैव यू एनी क्वेश्चन अप टू हियर?
नो सर.
ठीक है, तो और भी कोई है जिसकी अटेंडेंस ना हुई हो?
सर मनीवास ने.
मनीवास ने ठीक है बेटा. मनी एक
प्रशांत
कुमार, एज वेल मनु भारद्वाज है, जयेश दीक्षित, जयेश है, गौरव पांडे, फजल अहमद, धर्मजीत सिंह नहीं है. ठीक है, और भी कुछ पूछना चाहें तो बताइए, नहीं तो आज का लेक्चर यहीं पर स्टॉप करते हैं.
सर मेरी लगा दी आपने.
क्या नाम है बेटा आपका?